In this video, we're going to take a look at how to get started with Cinemachine. We're going to look at how we can use Cinemachine to keep a camera looking at a target transform as it moves across the screen, as well as how to dynamically follow a target transform as it moves around the world. In our additional lessons, we'll be looking at some of Cinemachine's more advanced features, such as following a specific path and transitioning between different camera styles during gameplay. Cinemachine is a powerful cinematic toolset that allows us to dynamically control our camera to always get the best composition for our project. To get started with Cinemachine, you'll first need to download the package from the Assets Store and import it into your project. In this scene, we're using a timeline sequence to have a character walk across the screen. Right now, we have a stationary main camera, and when our character moves too far away, they exit frame. We want to keep them in shot as much as possible. Ideally, we would like our camera to pan and keep them in the frame as they walk. We can do this dynamically using Cinemachine. We first need to add a Cinemachine brain component to the main camera. The Cinemachine brain component acts as the main hub for our Cinemachine components. It takes control of the main camera and allows us to create and control a number of different virtual cameras. Next, we'll drag the main camera into our timeline and choose Cinemachine track. Then, we'll right-click in the new Cinemachine track and choose Add Cinemachine Shot Clip. In the inspector, we can assign a pre-existing virtual camera for this clip. However, in this instance, we want to create a new virtual camera. So let's click on the Create button. This creates a new virtual camera in our hierarchy for us to use. With a transform assigned to the lookAt property of the virtual camera, Cinemachine will pan the camera to track the selected transform across the screen. So, if we select a transform component on our character, such as this one, and then assign it, our camera will now follow this point on our character as they move, and our character no longer walks out of frame. We can fine-tune the composition of how our camera looks at our selected transform component by changing the aim properties in the inspector or directly adjusting the frame guidelines in the game window. Cinemachine will not start tracking our target until it reaches the boundary of the dead zone. If, for instance, we don't want our camera to start panning until the character reaches the edge of the screen, we should increase the dead zone. Similarly, if we would like our camera to continuously pan, we should decrease the dead zone. The soft zone controls how much room the target has to move within the composed shot. A larger soft zone will create a more natural feeling to the camera movement, whereas reducing the soft zone will cause the camera movement to become more precise and feel more mechanical. In this project, I'd like our camera to only start panning when our character moves towards the edge of the screen, and I'd like there to be some freedom in the camera's framing. So, I've got both dead zones and soft zones set quite high. It is recommended to experiment with these settings to get the best style of camera movement for your project. Now, let's suppose we'd like a different shot that follows our character. Let's create another Cinemachine clip on our track and a new virtual camera. We'll position the camera to a different spot and assign our character's transform to the follow property of the virtual camera. Cinemachine then keeps the camera's transform relative to the follow target. If we play the scene in timeline, the camera will cut from our stationary camera to the follow camera. Using the blend transitions on the clips, we can transition between both of our Cinemachine camera shots. We can trim and position the clips to further customize how the transition will look. As you can see, with just a few simple steps, it's easy to get started composing and controlling shots dynamically with Cinemachine. In our additional lessons, we'll be looking at some of Cinemachine's more advanced features, such as following a specific path and transitioning between different camera styles during gameplay. For more information on Cinemachine and for more Unity tutorials, please be sure to follow the links below. Thanks for watching.